bishop and win. Amen. She is truly a gift and a jewel to the entire denomination, but she's also our gift and jewel here in the South Florida Conference. She, for the all of my life, has been a part of my life and a part of our family. I thank God for her, because when I was a seminarian coming up through school, I went to seminary straight out of college, so I didn't have a job first. So what I'm trying to tell you is I was dead broke, amen. And I was going to school on faith and on some prayers and on some ramen noodles and all those other things that I was going to school on. And Dr. Kelly, whenever I was nearby or in town, she would reach out to me, make sure I was okay, and give me an opportunity to practice my sermons in her church. And that meant a lot to me, because, you know, young preachers are like film. They have to have some exposure to develop. Amen. And she provided all those Kodak moments for me down through the years. So I'm just so grateful to have her as being a mother in my life to come and speak to us on Mother's Day. And we are glad to have her, and we are honored to have her, because she could have been any other church this morning, but she's here with us at Payne Chapel. Amen. Amen. So as we get ready to receive a word, I want you to extend your hand toward our preacher this morning and just say simply this: preach. Preacher, preach. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's put our hands together for these young people as they prepare to bless us through singing.
what a wonderful choir. Oh, the Lord is good to this church. Let's give these young people another hand. And the musicians. It is my distinct pleasure and honor to be invited to come here another year. And I want to say to you, to this especially distinguished pastor, I call him my God grandson, because his father said I look like his mother. And I say, I can't be your mother, I can't be your stepmother, but I can't be your godmother. So I adopted this family as the Green family. Amen. To his beautiful wife, loving wife here, the First Lady of Payne Chapel, beautiful children. We are privileged to have this beautiful group of ministerial staff here, dedicated, and our offices, the stewards, the great stewards of the church, and other offices here. I want to thank my family for coming. I have my, who was not here earlier, my granddaughter, my great-granddaughter, and my new grandson. Now, he related to Beyonce, so I'll just tell y'all that. And let us pray. Almighty God, speak. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Today our text is from Job, the 42nd chapter and the 10th verse. Job 42nd chapter and the 10th verse. Yeah, three important points in there we will address today. And the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. So the subject today is faithful mothers brings us blessings as well as double blessings. Some of the most faithful sayings about life that our mothers try to teach us is quoted by Dr. Murdoch, which describes every day of our life as a picture of your choices. Now, your decisions and what you magnify in your mind as your chosen focus. Therefore, our mothers reminded us that you will focus your future with the speed of choices. Your speed may be crawling, walking, running like a car or a jet. And every decision you make reveals your doubts or your faith. God designs your future, but you decide your future. Therefore, every decision we make decides either our fears or our faith. Our faithful mothers know this, so listen to them and obey them. Our mother's secular, faithful teachings from her positive experiences. But we need to listen and obey our mother's faithful teachings from a biblical perspective. Oh, for our mothers know how to rely on God's words in the Bible. And she knows how to relate to those stories of faith written in the Bible too. She knows that one of the most powerful books in the Bible on faith is the book of Job. You see, the purpose of the book of Job was to demonstrate God's sovereignty. We spoke on it before, that God is Almighty God. Oh, she knows that. He's the most powerful God. And that Job gave us the meaning of true faith. Amen. We already sang this morning, faith of our mothers. Faith is so important. The book of Job addresses the question, why do the righteous suffer? Have you heard that question before? Some folks may ask that question in another way, in today's vernacular, by saying, what do we do when things get loose in a righteous Christian person's life? Well, after God put a hedge around Job and Satan and told him not to kill him, in Job's second chapter and third verse says, then the Lord said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He's blameless. He's upright. He's a man who fears God and shuns evil. And he still maintains his integrity, though you cited me against him to ruin him without any reason. After that experience, Job lost his family, his children, his cattle, his wealth, and his health. Now, there are two reasons that can become, things can become loose in our lives. First, it comes from Galatians 6th chapter and the 7th verse, which says, we reap what we sow. We pretty much understand that the Bible in the life of Job as a devout Christian, Job was not reaping what he sowed. Amen. And also we may be in that second category of reason, which is we may be tested for our faith in God. Amen. Just think about it. There may be times in our lives, like when our faith in God is tested. Times when Job experienced that experience. The important thing is that Job was going through all of the situations of losing everything, but he still remained faithful to God. And his friends are family. They falsely accused him, said that he secretly lived an ungodly life because they believed that he was reaping what he sowed. We can't judge people all the time on what we see happening to them. They must be doing something wrong. Amen. Now, the second thing is God might be giving us an example that we must have faith in God. And we must keep that faith in God because we might be tested like Job. You do not know that there's times when things that were nailed down, but now they'll be coming loose. Things that were secure, that they are falling apart. So the question today is, what should we do in a time of testing? When we are faced with major issues, we are faced with issues of equality, amen, and quality of health care. We are faced with issues of education, public education issues, children issues. We are faced today with women pay increase issues, social justice issues, civil rights issues, amen, and regardless of race, creed, or color. Put it this way, there is hope. But then, what are we going to do about it? I've been told that there are three kinds of people. Amen. The first person is the people who watch what's happening. Amen. They know what's happening, but they just watching. I see what's going on. And the second group of people, they make things happen. Amen. They vote. They go out. They work with people. They work to try to solve the problems. Amen. But then there's a third group of people, they just don't know what's happening. That's it. But there is hope. Things in Luke 6, chapter 37th verse, when Job was going through his crisis, his friends were criticizing him, shunning him, because they thought he was reaping what he sowed and he was living a secretly life of sin. He looked at the scriptures of Luke 6 chapter and 37 verse describes what he did and how that situation was. That scripture tells us to judge not, that you be not judged, but his enemies judged him. And also says that to condemn not, you be not condemned. They condemned Job, but Job did the third thing it says in that verse. He said, forgive, and you shall be forgiven. So that's where we are right now. Job, as he was tried, and after he successfully proved to God that he was going to keep his faith no matter what happened, then God broke his silence on Job. And when he broke his silence, he took him out of captivity. And when he took him out of that captivity, what he did for Job, he gave Job his blessings because he prayed for his friends. Amen. If you pray for your friends who are enemies as well, then God honors that. Amen. Because sometimes we have problems that we thought that we were doing the right thing, because I'm not going to bother with her no more. I'm going to speak to him again. Amen. But God doesn't want that. He wants us to still be in love and harmony with each other. Amen. And so we've got to do that. Our mothers try to teach us to love you one another. Amen. And that's what the Job, the 46th chapter and 10th verse said. After Job prayed for his friends, he gave him a double portion. Amen. That should tell us something right there. Amen. And so Job got double for his trouble. Amen. And I want you to know he got his family back. He got his cattle. He got his wealth back. Job got double blessings. Now the Lord wants me to give a word to those mothers of us here, any of us who mothers have gone on. Amen. I've been talking to people this week, and they were telling me, well, my mother, you know, they get that depression, I understand. And I'm in the category myself, but the Lord brought me out through his word. And he told me to tell the mothers today who have lost their mothers now, a word for us as faithful mothers who have, they have gone to heaven. Amen. So we must celebrate them. 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter and the 6th verse tells us where they are. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And in Hebrew, the 12th chapter and the 1st verse says, she is among a great cloud of witnesses. Just think about it. By looking down here on us today, wouldn't she be happy to know that we are in church today? Amen. With our families. Amen. Let's go. Amen. And just look at how she may be looking down on you today. Amen. Every day, but especially here in the church today. I want to know that you don't have to worry about her, because she's absent in the body, but she's present with the Lord. But wouldn't she be happy? Amen. And then we have an angel in every church. Amen. The Lord took me to Revelations. The angel in every church. So look at Revelations, the 2nd chapter, the 8th through the 11th verses. Amen. This is a one verse that tells us not only that they are angels, but what the angels telling us, the church, a message to the church today. And it says, an angel of the church wrote, church, I know your works and your tribulations. Amen. We might be suffering a little bit like Job, that they know it. Amen. And then, not for these things which thou shalt suffer, But be thou faithful unto death. Yeah. Amen. We got to keep on holding on because to God's unchanging hand, because it is the faithful, amen, who will endure to the end. Yeah. Amen. Let's teach our children to hold on. Although things might be look dark to them, or they might not be getting as much praise as they should for what they get, or they might not be getting what they desire to get. They could be mistreated too in the school circumstances. Amen. But if they remain faithful and just trust God, teach them how to trust the Lord. Amen. Everything will be all right. And he said, if you be faithful unto death, I will give you a crown of life. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said to the church. And in closing, I want to say that our mothers know God's word. When Jesus was on the cross at Calvary, amen, he said those words. He said he was looking at the whole group of people who were about to kill him and stone him and put him to death. But he said to them, forgive them, for they know not what they do. God wants us to forgive each other. He wants us to take this seriously. Amen. Because he didn't reward Job because he was just a good man and had faith, but because he forgave his friends. Amen. Forgive people. Amen. Stop holding on to grudges. Oh, we know a lot of people, I don't talk to them. Don't go to that family. Oh, don't work with that family. We work with this family. Amen. We don't want that. Let's come together with love and peace. That is what the Lord wants. Amen. But I want you to know today he died for our sins. Amen. And he hung on the old rugged cross. He was buried in the tomb. And on the third day, he got up. He got up. He arose with all power in his hand. There's nothing too hard for God. It's nothing with faith. God has told us that if we have faith, amen, that we will receive grace. Grace is our salvation. We got to trust his words. Follow what those faithful mothers told us to do. Well, I want you to know you go and get your blessings today. Amen. You can get your blessings from Job. When Job said, first of all, you must keep your faith. If you keep your faith in God, amen. And secondly, if you will forgive those who did wrong things against you, like Job did when he forgave those friends, I want you to know then you can go and get your double blessings. God wants us to have double blessings like he gave Job. Just keep the faith. May God bless you and have a beautiful, wonderful Mother's Day.
Amen. Come on, join me by standing all over the church. Come on, let's give God some praise. Is there anybody that could use a double blessing in here today? Come on, you ought to give God some praise. If you know what it is to go through and be grateful on the other side, give God some praise. If they tried to hurt you, they didn't even apologize, but you forgave them anyway. Come on and give God some praise. The reason why I'm telling you to give God some praise is because when praises go up, blessings come down. And the preacher told us that we can set ourselves up for a double blessing in here. Now, some of you are already singly blessed because you woke up this morning. You're singly blessed because you got clothes on your back. You're singly blessed because your stomach is not tearing a hole in your back. You're singly blessed because nobody kept you from coming in here today. But if you want to be doubly blessed, that's knowing that you're blessed no matter what happens on the other side. I know some of you didn't come here for all my preaching. You came to hear Dr. Kelly. But I came to tell somebody, don't you leave here today without getting the other part of your blessing. God said that I want to bless every mother in the house for every prayer that you lifted up for your child, for every night that you stayed up crying, for every night you almost scratched your hair out, wondering how God was going to make it for your children. I want you to know you're doubly blessed because God's still answering prayers. He's still making a way out of no way. He's still protecting your children. And what you pray for now, God's going to bless you with it on the other side. Do you believe it today? Somebody shout yes if you receive that double blessing. Somebody shout glory if you receive that double blessing. I dare somebody to lift up holy hands and say thank you, Lord, if you receive that double blessing. Come on, put your hands together and bless the Lord in this place. Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? Yeah. Amen. Today is a good day. Because one, we know first and foremost, I got away from the hashtag today. We know first and foremost, we're all overcomers. Amen. I think the preacher, without even trying to, she hit on that.